The time has come. Execute Order 66.
This is going to be kind of a longer video because I've got stuff I've got to do today and I'm not going to be home for most of it. So probably big news will happen today and I'll be out running errands. Anyway, Tamara Morrison was at a convention in Melbourne, Australia and said some interesting things, which because he is connected, he's not a secret squirrel agent. He really actually is part of the Star Wars universe, playing every clone, Jango Fett, that you could imagine. So he played about 300,000 million bajillion characters. He had this to say about what is going on at Lucasfilm, and I wanted to read it to you. And it's pretty interesting. He said, "I think there are a few changes going on. We also come under the big umbrella known as Disney now, too," Morrison shared at the Supernova Comic-Con. So it's one of those things. The conversation, so it's one of those last conversations we had in L.A. Conversation started like, "Oh, look, we're having a few changes. We're having a few cutbacks." And when you hear that on the other end, you give up. You give up trying to negotiate for more money. And that's what he said. I mean, there it is in front of your face. Now, what could he possibly be talking about? What's going on at Disney? Oh, black pills like Yellow Flash, etc., etc. 7,000 people are losing their jobs. Now, I assume the black pills think it's all the good people, because heaven forbid Disney want to make money. Look, I'm going to be brutally honest here. We live in a world where people who, for whatever reason, back in the day, did not mature beyond the age of 14, okay? And they walk around with a chip on their shoulder the size of Mount Everest, and they think they're part of the news. They think they're part of the media. And in some ways, they are. But it's more like Weekly World News Bat Boy media. Okay, it's not actual concise thought and logic and rationality. If you bring up failing stocks, investors complaining, they'll bring up a quasi version of George Soros. And it's like, he doesn't have anything to do with this. This is but anyway, let's talk about Tamara. Tamara Morrison played Boba Fett in a show that didn't do well because the perpetual 14-year-old fanboys that bully everybody around to make them believe what they think they should believe didn't like it and set the narrative, okay? Then they got their claws into Kenobi, which they were completely wrong about, but hey, you know, why listen to somebody who actually watched every fucking episode and knows A New Hope better than the back of her hand? All right. These are people who aren't familiar with the lore of Star Wars. They never watched the Clone Wars. They didn't even watch, I mean, parts of Rebels that I liked. I'm at least familiar with it. And it's kind of sickening in my mind that we have to sit here and suffer through their ranting and raving. And trust me, the next part of the video, I'm going to go full bore into this. Tamara Morrison's talking about the cutbacks at Disney. He's talking about people getting fired and laid off at Lucasfilm. And he's talking about changes being made there. All right, so let's put on our thinking caps, people. Let's, you know, take a red pill and not a black pill, and get back to reality. Talk about how much money Disney invested in Lucasfilm. They bought it for $4.3 billion. They invested, I'm going to say, at least $2 to $3 billion in each park. Right? And I think another extra billion at Disneyland, California, because when they did the park, they violated a bunch of crazy Californian environmental codes, and they had to tear things down and rebuild it. Okay, so I'd say about $7 billion right there. Okay, then add how much money they invested into the movies, the initial budgets, and then Kathy Kennedy's delusional reshoots, which made the movies worse, probably. When you look at it all, they probably invested about $10 billion. Okay, they've only net $2 billion. Okay, they only net about $2 billion. That is not a profit. Okay, and people like Pablo Hidalgo and the rest of the shills at Lucasfilm like to say they broke even. That's only if you look at gross profits. But if you look actually at what Disney brought back, they only made about $2 billion, which is a red, red, red line, okay? And it's really too bad that people that want Star Wars to be good, that are disappointed in what Disney's made so far, can't understand that, all right? The wrong people are setting the narrative for the fandom, all right? They're making it difficult for people to enjoy anything, all right? When I hear, I want to bring Disney to the ground. Well, you're not going to, unless Putin decides to drop a nuke over Orlando, which isn't going to happen. He's not stupid, okay? Maybe our own government would, but Putin won't. That's the only way you're ever going to burn down Disney, all right? That's the only way. So now, we've got one of the major actors involved in Star Wars, a linchpin of at least two different characters, if not several, saying that there are changes coming to Lucasfilm. Now, the Black Pills will say, blah, blah, blah's leaving, and blah, blah, we'll talk about that. No, he's not. They're not. Bob Iger has to make a profit. Bob Iger has to fix what he broke. Bob Iger's not going to keep people who continue to run roughshod over the franchise. He can't afford it, okay? And if he can't keep it from happening, he's going to sell Lucasfilm off. He's going to spin it off, okay? Those are his only two choices. He has no other choices, okay? This is logic and rationality. Now, people can say I get mad and condescend to people. Yes, I do. And the reason why I do is that I'm not a simpleton, okay? I don't simp after people. I don't give a flying fuck what anybody thinks. I'm not here to be popular, okay? I'm here to get the word out, to help people understand what's going on, okay? And what Tamara Morrison said, when he said, I think there's a few changes going on. We also come under the big umbrella known as Disney now, too. Morrison shared at the Supernova Comic-Con and Gaming Convention in Melbourne, Australia, per Microsoft News Network. So it's one of the last few conversations we had in L.A. Conversation started like, oh, look, we're having a few changes. We're having a few cutbacks. And when you hear that on the other end of the line, it's no good trying to negotiate any more money, that's for sure. So we'll see what happens. Okay. So, what's he talking about? He's talking about Lucasfilm probably being rearranged, getting slimmed down, maybe consolidated into a new studio along with its sister, Marvel. Maybe they're getting spun off to be sold out. We don't know, but the idea that the good people are being let go is absolutely fucking ridiculous. It's irrational. And it also goes to how desperate Black Pills are to make money, and how desperate the actual bad guys here, that sequel trilogy shills like Jason Ward, Pablo Hidalgo, are to burn everything down, okay? They want you to think the good people are leaving, all right? They want you to think that. The reason why is because you'll leave the franchise. You're basically being manipulated into the what I call the scorched earth of Kathy Kennedy. She threatened she would do it, and she's trying to do it. That's what she did at Star Wars Celebration when she had that very public temper tantrum. Okay? So I'm going to address the big rumor going out that was started by the angriest YouTuber out there. And he really needs to just shut down his channel and take a walk out in the fresh air, because he's making everybody miserable around him too, including his own subscribers and the people who think he's their friend. Okay. This is an untenable situation, and it's toxic.
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
The fleet has moved out of light speed, and we're preparing to...
You have failed me for the last time, Admiral. Apology accepted, Captain Nida.
You will find that it is you who are mistaken about a great many things.
So what is the stupidest thing I've ever heard this week? Among all the cuts that are happening at Lucasfilm, the fact that that are happening at Disney, we see Freeform and ABC combining. We see ESPN losing. We heard 100, and now we're 500. And we know that Burbank, the studios there, are not going to be left unscathed this week. That there will be layoffs every day till Friday. Okay. Stupidest rumor started by Yellow Flash is Favreau's done. And the reason why is because they saw at the end of The Mandalorian, and I'm going to say this, I don't believe Yellow Flash actually watched The Mandalorian. 90% of these people complaining have not seen it. Paz Vizsla sacrifices himself for Din Djarin, try to save him, and to try to save Bo-Katan. Now, these people have never watched Clone Wars, so they don't know who Paz Vizsla is related to. Okay, Paz Vizsla is either the grandson or the son of... Okay, so Paz Vizsla is the Mandalorian warrior and leader of the Death Watch during the Clone Wars, and he wielded the dark saber, which belonged to his ancestor Tar Vizsla, who actually created the dark saber. And Pre Vizsla actually secretly sided with Count Dooku, so he was a traitor to Mandalore, and he was on the other side of... he was directly opposed to the Duchess Satine and House Kryze. So Dooku didn't long, and he longs to restore the warrior heritage of the Mandalore by overthrowing his pacifist government led by Duchess Satine. His many attempts to do so fail, and eventually breaks ties with Dooku. Vizsla later allies himself with Darth Maul and Savage Opress. Together they recruit the Black Sun, Pike Syndicate, and the Hutt Clan to form a criminal alliance known as the Shadow Collective. After Vizsla ousts Satine with the help of the Collective, he betrays his allies except for Death Watch, and has them imprisoned. And that's Pre Vizsla. Pre Vizsla basically went against everything that Mandalorians stand for, and he paid for it, and he ended up losing to Darth Maul. Okay. When Paz Vizsla offers himself up to save Satine's sister, Bo-Katan Kryze, he basically is gaining penance for his family. Okay? Doing an act of penance to hit the family and basically saving his family's name. Okay? That's what that was about. It has nothing to do with Jon Favreau being tired and blah, blah, blah. Ahsoka season 2 is already in the vault. They're getting ready, from what people have said, to film Mandalorian season 4 in October. So what's going on here? Okay. This is misinterpretation. This is not knowing the lore of Star Wars. And this is, again, emotionally stunted, emotionally immature fanboys who've made up this because they never watched the Clone Wars, okay? They never watched any of it. And they see the character that Jon Favreau voiced dying, so therefore they make the illusion that he's leaving. He's not leaving. Okay. He's got shit to do. And, you know, from what we've heard and we speculate is that he was going to give Daisy Ridley a chance to give Rey a heroic way out. And when he walked off the stage at Celebration, when she walked out to no fanfare, no clapping, at Celebration this year, he walked off because he had been blindsided too by Kennedy's temper tantrum. Daisy took part in that because Daisy is an out-of-touch, landed gentry, British fop bitch, okay? That's what she is, all right? I would much rather hang out with Princess Kate talking about whatever than Daisy Ridley, who actually takes herself too seriously, all right? And that is what happened. Okay. She took part in Kennedy's temper tantrum, and that's why. All right. Now, when can we expect some sort of word on these cuts? This week. Yesterday was ESPN Day, Freeform and ABC. All right. Tomorrow it could be Marvel. Today it could be Marvel or Lucasfilm. Tomorrow it could be Marvel or Lucasfilm. Thursday could be both. Okay, we don't know. I do know this, that the idea that Jon Favreau is leaving all because a character he voiced died protecting Bo-Katan is absolutely the most dumbest, stupidest, emotionally overwrought, crybaby piece of shit rumor I've ever heard in my life, and the people perpetuating it should be embarrassed, okay? They should fucking be embarrassed. This is Steph, frustrated as hell. See you around the galaxy.